Loxley.
Good evening. Victorians who refuse to wear masks on public transport now face the threat of fines. Police are preparing to embark on a two-week enforcement blitz following a sharp drop in compliance rates. Andrew Lund has the details.
The signs at Richmond Station are clear, but not everyone is on board.
I've been disappointed to see myself getting on the train and the tram, a major and significant reduction in the number of people wearing masks.
The issue was obvious as footy fans arrived for this afternoon's games. The government says just 53% of train passengers and 52% of tram passengers are now wearing masks. So from tomorrow, police and PSOs will begin a two-week enforcement blitz.
Our police members will be providing masks to people in the first instance. This is about encouragement.
But while tram passengers face the prospect of fines, tram drivers are exempt.
Tram drivers do not have to wear a mask because they are in their own closed cabin by themselves.
It arguably doesn't set a good example for passengers who are required to wear a mask.
So far, there have been no confirmed cases of community transmission occurring on public transport.
The question is, why has the state government chosen right now to redouble its efforts to impose mask bans on public transport?
From tomorrow, transport workers aged under 50 will be eligible to receive the Pfizer vaccine. But with the national rollout making slow progress, the mask mandate will likely remain for some time.
The mandatory wearing of masks on public transport is here for the foreseeable future.
Because after another day with zero new local cases...
Today is the 85th or maybe 86th continuous day of no community transmission.
There's a fear complacency is creeping in. Andrew Lund, Nine News.